अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ साजिद अली। इन माय फर्स्ट लेक्चर आई डिस्कस विद यू मुस्लिम्स इन इंडिया। सो इट वाज माय द पार्ट वन ऑफ दिस लेक्चर एंड इन दैट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अरब कंक्वेयर इन सिंध, महमूद गजनवी एंड मोहम्मद गोरी। सो दिस इज़ द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस लेक्चर। इन दिस lecture we are going to discuss Delhi Sultanate from 1200 to 1526. And dear friends, in Delhi Sultanate there are five dynasties: Silev, Khilji, Tughlaq, Sayyid and Lodhi dynasty. So start from Silev dynasty. The Silev dynasty was founded in 1206 to 1290. It was founded by Qutbuddin Aibak, and Qutbuddin Aibak was a governor of Mohammad Ghori. Qutbuddin Aibak, after the Battle of Tarain in 1192, he was appointed as a governor and viceroy of the Mohammad Ghori in Delhi, as I told you in lecture number one. So now, after the death of Mohammad Ghori, Qutbuddin Aibak established an independent Muslim state in Delhi. So Qutbuddin Aibak was from 1206 to 1210. In 1210 he died. So and this Silev dynasty is also called Mamluk dynasty. After Qutbuddin Aibak, Iltutmish is the son-in-law of Qutbuddin Aibak. He occupied the throne of Silev dynasty after Qutbuddin Aibak in 1211 to 1236. Iltutmish is also called the real founder of the Silev dynasty as well as Delhi Sultanate, because he was the first ruler of Delhi Sultanate who introduced some reforms. Just like he introduced coin with his name, and he made also a group of 40 people. They were the people of government. They were 40 peoples from different tribes. They just like Afghanis, Egyptians, Iranians, Turkish, and so on. They could select the ruler of Sultanate, and they had also power to dismiss the ruler. It was the reform of Iltutmish. After Iltutmish, Razia Sultana was the daughter of Iltutmish. She occupied throne in 1236 to 1240. She was also the first Muslim woman ruler in the subcontinent as well as in the world. After Razia Sultana, Bahram Shah was the son of Iltutmish, occupied the throne from 1240 to 1242. Masud was the grandson of Iltutmish. He also occupied the throne from 1242 to 1246. Bahram Shah and Masud were not experienced and strong rulers. That's why they could not continue their governments. After Masud, नसीरुद्दीन महमूद बिकेम द रूलर ऑफ सिलेब डायनेस्टी इन 1246 to 1266. ही वॉज ऑल्सो द सन इन लॉ ऑफ गयासुद्दीन बालबन वॉज वन ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड ब्रेव रूलर ऑफ दिल्ली सल्तनत बिकॉज ही मेड सम रिफॉर्म्स इन आर्मी एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. गयासुद्दीन बालबन वॉज फ्राम 1266 to 1287. After Ghiyasuddin Balban, the remaining rulers of Celeb dynasty were not strong and capable. That's why the Celeb dynasty was ended in 1290. Khalji dynasty was founded by Jalaluddin Khalji in 1290 to 1320. The real name of Jalaluddin Khilji was Malik Feroz. He became the ruler of Khilji dynasty from 1290 to 1296. Some writers also says that Jalaluddin Khilji was killed by Alauddin Khilji, and Alauddin Khilji was the son-in-law of Jalaluddin Khilji. Alauddin Khilji became the ruler of Khilji dynasty in 1296 to 1316. He was the famous ruler in the Delhi Sultanate because he introduced some reforms, just like he introduced price control, second, formation of strong army, third, land survey system, in price control, Alauddin Khilji fixed the rates of commodities to serve his people, to serve his state, and also to maintain his army, because he want to make a strong army to face different enemies of the state. He also formed an strong army, land survey system. Alauddin Khilji took the share of production of land 50%. That's why he introduced land survey system. So Alauddin Khilji is the famous ruler in the period of Delhi Sultanate, and he was also the forerunner of Sher Shah Suri and Akbar the Great. Qutbuddin Mubarak was the third son of Alauddin Khilji. Qutbuddin Mubarak became the ruler of Khilji dynasty in 1316 to 1320, but he was inexperienced ruler. That's why he could not continue his government, and in this way Khilji dynasty ended. Tughlaq dynasty After Khilji dynasty, the Tughlaq dynasty was founded by Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. His real name was Ghazi Malik. And it was from 1320 to 1414. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq became the ruler of Tughlaq dynasty from 1320 to 1325. After the death of Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq became the ruler of Tughlaq dynasty. Muhammad bin Tughlaq, his real name was Alagh Khan. And he was also known as Juna Khan. He became the ruler from 1325 to 1351. He is also called the mixture of opposite because he introduced some projects and plans, but they failed because of his maladministration and mismanagement. Muhammad bin Tughlaq introduced a project. He transferred capital from Delhi to Daulatabad. Second, currency reforms. Third, tax, imposed tax on the Doab. It was the fertile area. And he also attempted to conquer Tibet and China. All his projects failed because of some reasons. And that's why he is called the mixture of opposite. After Muhammad bin Tughlaq, Feroz Shah Tughlaq from 1351 to 1388. Feroz Shah Tughlaq was not a good general and warrior, but he was interested to build cities, gardens, wells, and some utility works to serve public. That's why he built many cities, Ferozabad, Hisar Feroza, and so on. Ghiyasuddin II, Abu Bakr, both. Ghiyasuddin II from 1388 to 1389, and Abu Bakr from 1389 to 1394. Both rulers of Tughlaq dynasty were weak. After Abu Bakr, Nasiruddin Muhammad became the ruler of Tughlaq dynasty in 1394 to 1412. After Nasiruddin Muhammad, Daulat Khan Lodhi became the ruler of Tughlaq dynasty from 1412 to 1414. In this way, Tughlaq dynasty was finished. Because after Nasiruddin Mahmud and Daulat Khan Lodhi, no any ruler of Tughlaq dynasty was alive. And Tughlaq dynasty was ended. After Tughlaq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty. Sayyid dynasty was the peaceful dynasty. In Sayyid dynasty, no any kind of development and no any kind of possession and conquer. It was founded in 1451. Khizr Khan was the founder of Sayyid dynasty. Khizr Khan became the ruler of Sayyid dynasty from 1414 to 1421. After Khizr Khan, Mubarak Shah. Mubarak Shah became the ruler of Sayyid dynasty from 1421 to 1433. And Mubarak Shah, after Mubarak Shah, Muhammad Shah, the nephew of Mubarak Shah. Mubarak Shah was the son of Khizr Khan. In this way, after Mubarak Shah, Muhammad Shah became the ruler of Sayyid dynasty from 1433 to 1445. After Muhammad Shah, Alauddin Alam Shah became the ruler of Sayyid dynasty. He was the last ruler of Sayyid dynasty from 1445 to 1451. And in this way, Sayyid dynasty was ended. Then Lodhi dynasty. The founder of Lodhi dynasty was Bahlul Lodhi. Dear friends, it was the Afghani dynasty and was from 1451 to 1526. Afghani dynasty. Why we call it the Afghani dynasty? Because the rest of rulers of Delhi Sultanate were Turkish, but the rulers of Lodhi dynasty were not Turkish, they were Afghani. That's why we call it the Afghani dynasty. And the founder of this dynasty was Bahlul Lodhi. From he became the ruler of this dynasty from 1451 to 1488. After Bahlul Lodhi, Sikandar Lodhi became the ruler of Lodhi dynasty from 1488 to 1517. And Ibrahim Lodhi was the son of Sikandar Lodhi, and Sikandar Lodhi was the son of Bahlul Lodhi. Ibrahim Lodhi was the last ruler of Delhi Sultanate as well as Lodhi dynasty. Because after Ibrahim Lodhi, no any ruler was Delhi Sultanate. Babur attacked on Delhi Sultanate and killed Ibrahim Lodhi and formed Mughal Empire. That's why Ibrahim Lodhi is the last ruler of Delhi Sultanate. He became the ruler of Lodhi dynasty from 1517 to 1526. So dear friends, in Lodhi dynasty, Sikandar Lodhi also made Agra city. एंड गियासुद्दीन तुगलक बिल्ट द सिटी तुगलक आबाद सो डियर फ्रेंड्स इन दिस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड डिफरेंट डायनेस्टीज ऑफ दिल्ली सल्तनत फाइव डायनेस्टीज सिलेव खिलजी तुगलक सैयद एंड लोधी डायनेस्टी एंड दिस इज द पार्ट टू ऑफ लेक्चर नंबर वन द मेन टॉपिक ऑफ दिस लेक्चर मुस्लिम्स इन इंडिया एंड द सब टॉपिक ऑफ दिस लेक्चर दिल्ली सल्तनत एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट वॉच माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो kindly like subscribe and share my video thank you very much allah hafiz